What is going on, everyone? Hopefully you guys are doing well and that God has been present in your life, and may God bless you throughout watching this video. Okay, and so today again we'll be talking about the judges again, about how the people of the Israelites have disobeyed God, and that God had sent judges to help the Israelites through their struggles. And so today's passage, we will be in Judges chapter 4, verses 4 through 7 and 14 through 16. And we will also be in Judges chapter 5, verse 1 through 5 and 9 through 11. So follow along as I read this passage.
Now Deborah, a prophetess of the wife of Lapidoth, was a judging Israel at that time. She used to sit under the palm tree of Deborah between Ramah and Bethel in the hill country of Ephraim, and the sons of Israel came up to her for judgment. Now she sent and summoned Barak, the son of Abidom, and Kedesh, Naphtali. And she said to him, "Behold, the Lord of God of Israel has commanded, go and march to Mount Tabor, and take with you 10,000 men from the sons of Naphtali, and from the sons of Zebulun, and I will draw out you to Sisera, the commander of the Jabin's army, with his chariots and his many troops, to the river of Kishon, and I will give him into your hand." Deborah said to Barak, "Arise, for this is the day in which the Lord has given Sisera into your hands. Behold, the Lord has gone out before you." So Barak went down from the mountain of Tabor with 10,000 men following him. The Lord routed Sisera and all his chariots and all his army with the edge of the sword before Barak. And Sisera aligned him from his chariot and fled away on foot. But Barak pursued the chariots and his army as far as the Harosheth Hagoyim, and all the army of Sisera fell by the edge of the sword. Not even one was left. Then Deborah and Barak, the son of Abinoam, sang all day, saying that the leaders led in Israel, that the people volunteered, "Bless the Lord. Hear, O kings, give ear, O rulers. I to the Lord will sing. I will sing a praise to the Lord, the God of Israel. Lord, when you went out from Seir, when you marched from the field of Edom, the earth quaked and the heavens also dripped. Even the clouds dripped water. The mountains quaked at the presence of the Lord, this Sinai at the presence of the Lord, of the God of Israel. My heart goes out to the commanders of Israel, the volunteers among the people. Bless the Lord, you who ride on white donkeys, you who sit on rich carpets, and you who travel on the road. Sing. At the sound of those who divide flocks among the watering places, they shall recount the righteous deeds of the Lord, the righteous deeds of the peasantry in Israel." And the people of the Lord went down to the gates.
So amen to those scriptures that we just read. And so, you know, just throughout listening or actually reading the scriptures yourself, through this passage, we find that there's a lot of trust going on, and there's a lot of obedience that has to go on, and a lot of you know, spreading it to others and encouraging other people. And so today, this message will be about trust and obeying God, and also help others to do the same. And so beginning with this message, beginning in Judges chapter 4, verses 4 through 7, we come across a woman named Deborah. And so she was a judge at that time, and she was also a prophetess. And so, you know, like I said, judges is one thing, a prophetess is another thing. But yet she was both of these. For example, I'm not sure if you remember my like a lot of those lessons back in the day, but I talked about prophets a lot. And you know, what is a prophet? A prophet is someone who speaks out. And in this case, someone who speaks out what God has told them. And so she receives knowledge and wisdom, or I guess supernatural understanding from God, and she speaks whatever God speaks to her. And so that was she was one of those. But she was also a judge, and so someone who you could say settles disputes as well. And so she was one of the judges that God has sent to save his people, but also a judge to like Judge Judy, settle dispute. Boom, guilty, innocent, whatever. Yeah, so something like that. So she has a tough job to do, since she has both of these things. But yet she has the power to save the Israelites. And so in this case, she summoned a guy named Barak. And Barak is he's a naval army commander. And so she told him about God's promise. It was like she heard from God herself, because she was a prophetess. And so she heard from God saying, you know, go up against this army commander of the opposing army named Sisera. And so go face him in battle, and he will, like, God will give him victory. And so that was God's, in a sense, promise to Barak. And so, but then the thing is, he was still scared. And if you guys have heard anything about this story, it was, he was scared, but then he had asked Deborah to go along with it. It's like, "I won't go into battle unless you come with me." And so it was very brave on her part as well.
Woman power.
And so, yes, but just despite that, no, she did go into battle with him. And then verses 14 through 16 now, when they were in battle, and when they were, I guess you could say, they saw victory. Deborah encouraged Barak to, I guess, charge into battle. And that's exactly what Barak did after hearing you could say some encouragement from Deborah, in order that push in order to like have him fulfill God's command and to trust and obey God. There we go. Barak received that encouragement, that push from Deborah to trust and obey God. And through trusting and obeying God, they were victorious in this battle. And so in Judges chapter 5, verse pretty much everything, 1 through 5 and 9 through 11, it talks about you know, how both of them sang all day, Deborah and Barak. They sang all day long about the victory that God had provided them that day after defeating like every single one of the, like it says not even one was left standing on the opposing side. And so that was like a big victory on their part, and it was all because of God. And why did they choose to sing instead of just tell everyone about it? Well, remember one of my lessons is like, why is it easier to like remember a song versus remember just someone speaking it out to you? Because it's catchy. And so in this case they were or you could say it's easier to communicate as well. And so to sum this this message up, it's remember, this is about trusting and obeying God and helping others to do the same. And so in this one, how does it apply to you and I, for instance? Well, you know, we face many trials along our way. Maybe, I mean, I'm not sure how you guys go through your trials and struggles as well, but it's God has his plans for you. And so he's the only one who knows how to help you get to that destination, or like a very hard area of your life that you're going through as of this moment, and like you're desperately looking for victory, and God can help you through that only if you trust and obey him, that he can lead you through. And so in this case, Deborah, she knew that Barak could win because God was on his side. And so Barak needed that little push in order to get him to succeed. And so maybe someone, or maybe you, for instance, you could be that Deborah to someone else because you trust and obey God, or maybe someone is going to encourage you to do the same. And so maybe after, if you have like had an instance where you have survived something or been victorious out of life's harsh aspect in your life, it's like when you tell other people about it, it's like it's your personal testimony to them, so that they can be encouraged as well, and that they can learn to trust and obey God as well. And so that's how it relates to us all. And so that was my lesson for today. I hope that it encouraged you to go out and do the same. And so I pray that God be with you in every aspect of your life. And I pray that you make him a part of your daily life and get to fellowshipping with him more often and fellowshipping with other people. So thank you so much. Have a blessed week, and may God bless you guys.